There is a new development in the story of dozens of Canadians held in Syria over alleged links to the so-called Islamic State. Human Rights Watch is demanding the Canadian government urgently bring its citizens home, something other countries have already done. The report says there are 47 Canadians being held in detention camps. 8 of them are men, 13 are women, and there are 26 children, most of them under the age of 6 and born in Syria to Canadian parents. The Canadian government won't confirm any of those numbers. None of the detainees have been charged with any crime, and Human Rights Watch says they're being held in deplorable conditions. As Abigail Beeman reports, the idea of bringing alleged ISIS members home isn't something that sits well with everyone.
I don't think that there's one person here that's not traumatized.
Interviewed by Global News in 2019, Kimberly Pullman is one of the 47 Canadians in Syria that Human Rights Watch is calling to be repatriated.
We are languishing in these, you know, dire and inhumane conditions without being charged with any crimes.
Meeting criminal charges in Canada is a lot more comfortable than what they're doing now. So that's their motivation for coming home. They're starving, they're sick.
The report, Bring Me Back to Canada, says the Canadian government may be unlawfully withholding or limiting effective consular assistance.
The situation in Syria continues to be extremely dangerous. There are countries that have presence on the ground in Syria. Canada is not one of those countries.
They can't provide these services is really not consistent with what I've seen on the ground myself when I traveled to Syria and what I know of other countries who have actually affected repatriation.
Leah West says there are ways to help Canadians. She visited two of the camps named in the report last year. She's sure conditions are even worse now. And while she says there's no clear legal obligation for the government to repatriate, the situation is complex.
Especially those principles that underlie our international human rights obligations with this government really seems to espouse, especially in its most recent bid for a UN Security Council seat, the efforts with respect to women, peace and security. Those values, I don't think, are being adhered to by the government's refusal to bring these Canadians home.
What we see from the government is just a desire not to engage with a challenging situation and kind of look the other way. They haven't been very effective at putting a plan in place to actually prosecute people when they come back.
Conservatives are opposed to bringing back ISIS fighters, but say children are another story. Global Affairs says the government is particularly concerned about children and they're reviewing the report, but the ability to provide any consular help is, quote, extremely limited. Abigail Beeman, Global News, Ottawa.